Hello, YouTubers. You're in an all-new episode of The Final Cut, and since it's a Christmas season, I decided to revisit the 1984 film, Gremlins. Gremlins is a film directed by Joe Dante. You may recognize his work in Small Soldiers, also is written by Christopher Columbus, who would later on write Goonies, Young Sherlock Holmes, and go on to direct Home Alone and Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. And Gremlins could be considered as a monster movie or a creature feature. It's not entirely an explicit horror film, but it definitely is in the horror genre. It's a little bit lighter, but despite being PG, this and Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom are main reasons why PG-13 exists as a rating. So, Gremlins, what is it about? Well, you have this character of Billy Peltzer, played by Zach Galligan, and his father is an inventor. He sells things, and this little kid in this, like, market area at the beginning of the film introduces him to his grandfather, and they find this creature of the Gremlin, who later on ends up being Gizmo. And all they had to do was follow three simple rules. Don't feed it after midnight, don't get it wet, and don't put it into the light or it'll kill him. And pretty much what happens is that they raise Gizmo, and he accidentally gets wet when a friend comes over. Yeah, freaking Corey Feldman. And it multiplies. Well, the other little gremlins aren't exactly like Gizmo, they're troublemakers. And they mess with Billy's clock. They're not supposed to be fed after midnight, and when they are fed, they start going through a metamorphosis stage and this egg cocoon thing, and then they become the monstrous gremlins, and they want to multiply and continue to multiply. And the whole film is pretty much like these little creatures turning into these monsters terrorizing this town during Christmas. So it's a very basic creature feature monster type of movie. Many other films and pop culture has been referenced from Gremlins, whether it be the Critters movies, Stranger Things with Darton's character, or Furbies. Yeah, Furbies do look a little bit like a gremlin. I always thought that. Besides Zach Galligan, you also have Phoebe Cates as Kate Berenger, his love interest. Corey Feldman in a role, as well as Judge Reinhold in small parts. Judge Reinhold, I think, was supposed to have a larger part in the film. They cut it down. It was supposed to be over 2 hours and 40 minutes. Ended up being an hour and 40 minutes. And it has a very reasonable pace. What I like about this, what makes it like a horror film, is that they don't entirely show you the creatures at the beginning. Gizmo is slowly introduced, and there's some wonderful works of stop-motion animation and animatronics. And it's just amazing. It still really holds up to today in a pre-CGI world. It's just nice to see something that's just like animatronic or stop motion, or just other means of creating creatures that feel lifelike. It doesn't feel fake. Something about it feels very real. It's very effective, much in the way of like Yoda in The Empire Strikes Back. But I love it. I love this character setup of Gizmo, and then ultimately these monsters spawning from him and them having to stop these gremlins. It's your basic monster story. You do have certain human characters who are in fact worse than the gremlins, but once the gremlins come in, it's pretty effective. They don't show you its monstrous form at first. It's done through shadows or illusion, or it's just done very quickly until the final battle, until you start seeing multiple versions of them. That is when the film gets into overdrive and we really get to see these creatures just terrorize everything. It's much like Jurassic Park or like the classic creature movies, where it's what makes it scary is the unseen versus the seen. And this film, I don't know if it was me watching it as a kid, but it's not really that scary now, but I still count it as a horror movie. It is in the horror genre, but there very much is some levels of comedy, dark comedy at that, and they do feel like these crazy caricatures, these crazy cartoon characters that just wreak havoc. They're little troublemakers, they're gremlins, and it's just crazy in that regard, and have it on this Christmas backdrop makes it probably one of the darkest Christmas movies. Like, seriously, it really does. You may recognize some other people from other Joe Dante films, but he definitely has his stamp on this with the humor and the dark nature of it. Also, even though it was filmed on location, it was also filmed around the same town set of Back to the Future, and Joe Dante definitely wanted to have an old film type of vibe to this, a closed set, and just the way it looked, the stylized choices of the cinematography, make it look like an old monster movie. It definitely has that vibe, but it's very well shot. The atmosphere is really great as far as timing and suspense. Is it as gory as other horror films? No, but that doesn't mean it's not an effective horror film. It doesn't mean it's not in the genre. Gremlins, I would probably give a 4 out of 5. It's not the perfect movie, but it is a well-crafted kind of creature feature movie, and Howie Mandel does voice Gizmo. Gizmo's such a cute creature. In the original cut, he was supposed to turn into Stripe, the main villain, the leader of the Gremlins. Steven Spielberg produced this, and it's no accident. It definitely kind of has that stamp. He also produced Poltergeist and many other films during the 80s. But you have Gizmo there, and Steven Spielberg wanted to have a protagonist in the Gremlins that the audience and other characters can relate to. And I'm glad they did, because it shows you it's someone that's different, but also it adds another creature with Billy to help face against Stripe, the main Gremlin. And there's some really gnarly effects in this. And again, a lot of that is aided by practical uses of animatronics or puppets and just real stuff. It doesn't feel fake. It makes it feel very scary. And the Gremlins, they look like little Furby creatures, but when they're monsters, it's very scary. It's like reptilian and goblin, just demonic. They're supposed to be demons, basically, and it's just crazy. The bar scene is a standout. It is crazy when Kate's there by herself, and that last act at the mall and theater was very well done. Overall, I really like the vibe of this movie. It's very silly, yet dark. And I like the build-up. We get time to be invested in the characters, to spend some character development, progress the plot before, ultimately, shit hits the fan and the Gremlins are out. So yeah, it's a classic creature feature movie. I give it a 4 out of 5. If you haven't seen Gremlins, I'd be surprised. I don't know what kid hasn't seen Gremlins, but I can understand. I highly recommend seeing Gremlins and Gremlins 2 The New Batch if you haven't got a chance. If you have seen Gremlins, let me know your thoughts on this classic film. If you like this video, click the like button, comment, and subscribe for more videos. All they had to do was follow 3 simple rules, and they couldn't do that.